Twine 2 is a tool for interactive storytelling, but diverse enough that you can really pretty much make anything with it. Now that you know what Twine 2 is, let's make a game. Alright, so first we go to twinery.org/2, then we click on New Story. Story is going to be our challenge. And we're just going to click Add. That's going to give us an untitled passage. We can name this anything, like Start. And let's ask a question. What is your favorite color? And we can write anything in here. In fact, we can even style it, but I'll show you that later, maybe. Actually, so to stylize your text, Harlow, the default story format for Twine 2, actually uses Markdown. So bold, italics, and underlined is the bulk of what you can do. Links in the description for more ways to format your text. Anyway, on to the game. Maybe. So let's add some answers. What if our favorite color is red? So when you want to move from one passage to the next, that's called a link. And you do that by putting whatever text in brackets, and that'll send you to the next passage with that title. You can also do a link to a passage with a different title. This is how you do that, but it'll make sense in a bit. I'll show you. Like that. Or we could add our favorite color to be blue, or we could add our favorite color to be green. And now that we close that, we find something interesting, and that's that there are three options here, red, blue, and green. But what if we wanted to skip that, say? What if we wanted to say, I don't see color, I'm a nice person. What if we just did that instead? Now we have another one here. But that doesn't sound like we're really participating with the conversation, so let's just... Blue. Blue is pretty good. What a coincidence. Red is my favorite, too. Ew, gross. Who chooses green? It's like the rock standard color. You know? You just see it everywhere and decide that it must be your favorite. Right? Okay, so now that we've added all that, let's go to I don't see color, I'm a nice person. Well, how progressive of you. But man, could you just pick a color? And we're gonna send it right back to start. Okay, so now that we have all these, let's add some more links, yeah? Let's have them all linked to But what is your favorite color? And we're gonna do the same here. But what is your... Oh wait, hang on. But what is your favorite color? So those two are gonna link there, but we're gonna have red go somewhere else because we already know what the favorite color is. So, how relatable. Yeah, yeah, I'm not sure what to talk about now. Me neither. You watch sports? Okay. My favorite color is red. Are you interested in sports? Okay, so let's just go ahead and... Oh, okay. So these two are gonna go to the same place, so... Definitely not. No one likes sports. No, I don't like sports. And in fact, I don't know anyone who does. Pretty sure it's fake, if you ask me. No, definitely not. That's what we want. Okay. Well, this was a largely pointless conversation. I agree. So what were you saying? And now we get to do something fun. See, we don't want to make more stuff, so what we're actually just going to do is we're going to make it loop. And you can do that just by doing a hyphen, arrow key, and then putting in a passage name. So now... Excuse me? What are you doing here, kid? This was an unexpected wrinkle. Hang on. Oh, that's why. Yep, okay. So what happened there is I put a space before my passage name. Pretty common issue. Make sure you don't put any spaces at the beginning of your link. Yeah, bye. So now, if we go to this little button in the corner and click play, what's your favorite color? I don't see color. I'm a nice person. How progressive. Could you just pick a color, though? Green. Who chooses green? Green sucks. Sports sucks. Conversation sucks. So, I think it does work, but there is one thing I saw that was kind of weird. This one says start, and we don't want it to say start. It says... So instead, let's call it... Yeah, I guess I'll pick a color. And then we can link that to our start passage. Yeah, okay. So now, when we play, please. So now when we play, we can click, I don't see color, I'm a nice person. Yeah, I guess we'll pick a color. And we go back to the start. So we've made a game with multiple choice options that loops. So that's pretty cool, huh? I thought it was pretty cool. But yeah, if you want to make a more complicated Twine game, I have something that I made that uses all the same rules. It's based on SCP 2017. I'll release the... Why does this take so long to load every time? Anyway, so I've made a level based on SCP 2017, which is a small girl who if you touch her, you go a little crazy and then you die 7 days later. So I just made a little game about meeting that character and trying to figure that out for the first time. If it would load... Tell you what, I'll just cut to this later and, yeah. So I'll just show you the game, and that's open source. You can take a look if you're being all confused. Yeah. Oh, it loaded just then. Okay. So we don't know much. Here's what we do know. Take a look. This doesn't bode well for your chances. Go on in. Remain standing. Change the subject. Stronger defense. 7 days later, you die. And so that's how you make a text game in 10 minutes. I'm gonna put a bunch of useful stuff in the description, so be sure to check that out, like the Twine 2 format guide, so you can check out more formats, links to the tutorials that I have personally watched and think we all find useful. So yeah, thank you. Make sure to check the description. Bye.